God, we ask before we do anything else, Father, we ask you to forgive us of our sins and our sinfulness. Father God, I ask you to clean me up. Father God, I ask you to hide me behind the cross of Calvary. Father, if there's anything in me that should not be, Father, I ask that you remove it right now. Father God, allow me to stand and boldly proclaim your uncompromising gospel. Father God, you be God in all that we do, and we'll be satisfied with what you do. Bless us right now. Bless this service. Stir up the Holy Spirit that is in each and every one of us. Father God, to you be the glory for all that we do. In Jesus' name, amen. 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 More like him. Amen. Let's give the Lord a hand clap of praise for that praise team. Amen. Amen. For the praise team. We thank God. You know, the Bible says we have not because we ask not. And when we ask, he will supply. But he supplies in his own time. Amen. Amen. I can recall when we didn't have anybody but Sister Nelson by herself trying to do what she needed to do. And that's why I'm learning more and more each day. I'm learning to trust in God because he's able to do it, whatever it is. All we have to do, the reason we don't have it is because we fail to ask. Amen. We do give honor to God through our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. We do that by the power of the Holy Spirit. We're so grateful and thankful to be before you today. God bless each and every one of you that are here. We're just so elated and so good, so grateful to God about how good he really is. I'd like to also take, before I go any further, take this opportunity to thank each and every one of you for all the work that was done in presenting our 139th annual homecoming on last week. Outstanding work, each and every one of you. Give yourselves a hand. Give the Lord a praise for you. Amen. Did wonderful, wonderful work. Great teamwork. Great worship service to the Lord. And we're just going to keep on going higher and higher and higher. Amen. So we want to have some joy and some peace and some love up in this place. Amen. Yeah, we don't want to come in here with Satan. We're already defeated when we get here. You know, Satan does not have the ability to defeat us, though he will try. See, what Satan will do is Satan will work on the head. Amen. So he can mess it all up. You know, if the head is off center and the head's not doing, the tail has nothing else to do but follow the head. It does not have a choice. But Satan's a lie up in this place. We're going to give him praise. We're going to give him honor. And we're going to give him glory. We don't give him credit for anything. Amen. Because he doesn't deserve any. That's right. But we give God credit for everything. Amen. Because without him, we would be nothing and we would have nothing. So this is a joyous time for me to get to come back and be in front of each and every one of you, and that the Lord let you know that the Lord has blessed me to the point that I can be here. Aches, pain, had a lot of hurt going on, a lot of situation and circumstances that went on. But we're kind of like Joseph was when he went through all of his turmoil. Everything was going on with Joseph. God had a purpose. So we have to understand when things get all mixed up in our life and we're trying to figure it out because things didn't go the way they planned, we have to do like Joseph did and we say, but God. Yeah, yeah, yeah. When it's upside down, when it's all messed up, when it makes no sense, we have to say, but God. That's our opportunity to go before him. That's all he desires from each other. That's all he wants, to bless us. He wants to bless us, and we've let Satan confuse us. We let Satan mess us up with little bitty, itty bitty things that have no eternal significance whatsoever. And most of the time, it's about us. It's all about us. And that's where we go. That's where we miss the boat. Because it's all about the body. God put this body together for a purpose. We have a mission here at Mount Pisgah Baptist Church, and nothing else other than to lead people to Christ. So let this be a soul-saving station. If nothing else, that's the mission that we have. And guess what God has decided to do, that it takes all of us to do it. because he's collectively put this group of people together. We had nothing to do with it. We can't bring anybody to the Lord. We offer Christ to you. It's up to you to accept Christ. Amen? Amen. Let me go on. I got something else I'm supposed to be doing this morning. I feel good. I feel good because I'm grateful. I am so grateful. I'm so thankful. All it takes is just looking around. Just looking around a little bit. Just listening to what goes on. Listen to the news. Listen to all the negative stuff that goes on in the world. We garbage in, garbage out. And see, we got to start focusing on what is it that God has for us to do. The program that God already has. What God desires for us to do with and to and through each other. Get off that. Get off that. Don't waste your time on all of that. It is nothing but a waste. I mean, I got to see the news. For what? What are you going to do about the news? I mean, we get caught up in the world and all the worldly things, and it clouds our vision. We're not able to see what God would have us to do. We're not able to do our morning devotion. We're not able to do our Bible studies. We're not able to do our prayers or whatever because we get caught up in life. Amen. Well, guess what? God will never be second. He'll never accept second place in your life. Putting him first gives you opportunity that you never dreamed that you would have. Amen. He'll do things and put you in places that you never thought that you could be or that you could go. That's just the kind of God that he is. We got a little something on the word from the 11th chapter of Hebrews. Won't be long. I done just about said everything I'm going to say. 11th chapter of Hebrews, verses 1. Is that what I got up there? Yeah. 13, I'm sorry. My paper moved on me. There it is, right there where the pen is. That's it. We're going to go to Hebrews 13, 1 through 16. Amen? Amen? Okay, let's read. Let brotherly love continue, and be not forgetful to entertain strangers, for thereby some have entertained angels unaware. Remember them that are in bonds, as bond with them, and them which suffer adversity, as being yourselves also in the body. Marriage is honorable in all things, and the bed undefiled, but whoremongers and adulterers God will judge. Let your conversation be without covetousness, and be content with such things as ye have. For he said, I will never leave thee nor forsake thee, so that we may boldly say, the Lord is my helper, and I will not fear what man shall do unto me. Remember them which have the rule over you, who have spoken unto you the word of God, whose faith follow, considering the end of their conversation. Jesus Christ is the same yesterday and today and forevermore. Be not carried about with divers and strange doctrines. For it is a good thing that the heart be established with grace, not with meats, which have not profited them that have been occupied therein. We have an altar. Thereof they have no right to eat, which serves the tabernacle. For the bodies of those beasts whose blood is brought into the sanctuary by the high priest for sin are burned without the camp. Wherefore Jesus also, that he might sanctify the people with his own blood, suffered without the gate. Let us go forth, therefore, unto him without the camp, bearing his reproach. For there have we no continuing city, but we seek one to come. By him, therefore, let us offer the sacrifice of praise to God continually, that is the fruit of our lips, giving thanks to his name. But do good and communicate and forget not, for with such sacrifices, God is well pleased. Amen. Amen. God is well pleased. Faith that pleases God. A faith that pleases God. Last week, we talked about faith in action. This week, we want to talk about a faith that pleases God. There are different aspects of how we get there with this faith. There are different roads we want to take when we get there. But the first thing we want to do is to look at how God blesses us through our faith. We understand that way over in the 11th chapter, it tells us about how important faith is in our life. Number one, he tells us with our faith, it is impossible to please God. So that lets us know right off the bat that faith is an important attribute of who we are and what we plan to do through the Lord and what God plans to do through us. Romans 12 and 3 says, for I say, through the grace given unto me, that every man that is among you, not to think more highly of himself, but to look soberly according as God had dealt to every man a measure of faith. Don't you know each and every one of us has a measure of faith through the grace of God? Now, what we do with that is based on us, with that measure of faith. How do you grow your faith? How do we grow our faith? How do we faith that please? How do we get that faith that pleases God? Well, first thing is that we have to recognize who he is. If he is Lord in your life, that's a great start down the path of understanding who God is and what God plans to do to you and what God wants to do through you. It's already laid out for you. It says right here, it says, if we receive the witness of men, guess what? The witness of God is even greater. See, we'll listen to whatever. See, we have faith in just about everything, don't we? We do. Remember, God gave us a measure of faith, but we have faith that we're going to get in our car and it's going to go. It's going to take us where it want, where we need to go or whatever. We have faith most of the times on our jobs. We figure that we're going to go on our jobs. We're not expecting to go on the job and they tell us to hit the road. They tell us to leave or they tell us not to be a part of what's going on. Go on back. But our faith is so strong on things that we don't even see, that we don't even understand. We just take it for granted on everything else. But when it comes to God, it seems like we get tangled up with our faith. Right. See, God has told us and he's chosen us to be his people. He's chosen each and every one. See, you could not be here unless God had drawn you near to him. You don't have the ability to do it on your own. Brother John was teaching Sunday school this morning, and he said that, and he shook his head a little bit. He says, I thank God for him and his righteousness. He said, because without him, I'd have no righteousness at all. So we have to understand that our righteousness is imputed to us through what Jesus Christ did by God. None of us sit in here are righteous about anything. You know, we don't really deserve what we do, but because of the love of God, simply because he loves us just that much and he desires to have fellowship with us just that much, that he made it possible. He made a way for us to be redeemed back to him. Amen. To come back. Can you imagine that? To love it so much you can come back to it. You did what you did, and that's all right. We know that sin leaves a mark. Sin leaves a stain. But because of Jesus Christ and the shed blood on the cross, guess what? We're washed as white as snow through the blood of Jesus Christ. See, God even forgives that. Just because of Jesus Christ took his very own, his very best, he loved us just that much. All I'm trying to do is, don't you understand that love is a joining factor here? We can't have no faith if we don't love. We got to love and we got to have faith and we got to believe. And that faith that pleases God is that continuing faith, that faith that weathers the storm, whether it's good, whether it's bad, when it's hard, when it's up, when it's down, when things are not going right, when your friends have turned their backs on you, when your family has turned their backs on you, when your kids are acting crazy, when the husband is acting all out of whack, when the wife is acting all out of whack, that faith in God will see you through. Amen. He will carry you through. That's why it's so important to have that faith. See, we always have this saying when preachers will spit it out there in a minute. My faith is based on nothing less than Jesus Christ and his righteousness. Amen. Yeah, don't put your faith in nothing else. Always put your faith in him, because everything that you need, everything that you want, everything that you desire to be, guess what? Guess who has it? Guess who has it? God has everything that we need. Don't you remember when we were a little bitty? We didn't understand when we'd up there. We'd be up there and Allie Preston would have us up there singing. We'd be right back. We'd be singing, he got the whole world in his hands. He got the whole world in him. Boy, we would be so happy. We didn't know what we were talking about at that point in time, but we were really happy up there enjoying it. But we grew to know, had it not been for that, I wouldn't understand today that he actually does have the whole world in his hands. Why are we worried? Why are you distressed? Why can't you be what he's called you out to be? Why are you walking around with handcuffs on? You are free in Christ Jesus. He set us free. No longer do you have to be bound by the things you were bound with. He has set you free. He's given us a pass through Jesus Christ. Amen? Now it's up to us to move that faith and to grow that faith to the next height. And we ought to be struggling and scratching and clawing every day. Every round ought to go a little bit higher and higher. Every day when we go through those different situations and things, every day when we go through our trials and tribulations, as James said, every day when things just burden us down more and more, we ought to look unto Jesus, because every day that we make them trips, the rounds ought to go higher and higher. The steps are up. The steps are not down. The steps are not behind us. Everything in Christ is forward. Amen. We forward. Guess what? If it's already happened, ain't nothing you can do about it. Why would you spend 1 second worrying about what happened this morning at 7 o'clock? Amen. 7 o'clock is gone into eternity. You'll never see it again. But God has given us a future. He's given us a right now, if nothing else. And that's a praise to y'all. Missed your praise point. He's given us a right now. If he hadn't given us anything else, we have a right now. And even in that right now, God is worthy to be praised. He's worthy of all of our praise. Faith that pleases God. Faith that pleases God weathers the storm. It goes through things. It goes through life's ups. It goes through life's downs. He gave us some examples over there with heroes of faith. Over in the 11th chapter, he lays them all out. Guess what God did, though? See, we look at those individuals. Excuse me. Help me, Holy Spirit. We look at those individuals. We look at Abraham. We look at Enoch. We look at Rahab. And it tells us about all the great things they did because of the faith that they had in God. And guess what? Think about who he was using. Who was Abraham that he chose to use? Yeah. God chose him. Each and every one of those individuals, God chose them. But guess what? They were normal, regular, everyday people. Just like us. There was nothing special about them but their obedience, their faith. They had faith in God, even though they didn't get to see the promise that we know. But they didn't even know to get to see the New Testament era or whatever. But they had faith in God. See, the thing about Abraham is that Abraham was God's friend simply because he believed God. He did what he told him to do. See, we're going to have to prove at some point in time the test comes. See, we don't like being tested. I sure didn't like it in school. I hated it. Hated being tested. But how are you going to know how to get from A to B? The teacher has to know what you know, and the teacher has to know what you don't know. And it's no different in the word of God. See, God says, okay, come unto me, all ye that labor and heavy laden, and I'll give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn of me. Okay, and he told us to do all that. But what happens when we do that, when we take and he takes the yoke and we learn of him? What's the next step? Here comes the faith walk. When we've gone down, now you've got to walk in faith. In other words, there are scary things to your left and there are scary things to your right. See, we can't walk in fear. You know, faith and fear cancel out each other, right? Yes, so if we have faith, we walk. We don't worry about fear because he told us that he was going to be with us. Didn't he tell us that? Well, if we don't believe that, why don't we go to the 23rd number Psalm? Yeah. We go over there because we know what he told David, don't we? Yeah, he said, David said, the Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. What does he do? What does he make? He maketh me, doesn't he? Yeah. Lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside the still waters. Then guess what he said he does? He restores my soul. See, when the world has beat you down, when the world has taken you through the wringer and everything, all you have to do is call upon the name of the Lord and say, Lord, I need you. And then what David said, my shepherd, I need you. I need you so you can lead me to the path of righteousness for his name's sake. Yeah, you guess what? Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death. God is with every day we wake up in the very image of, when we lay down at night, we're in the very image of death. Each and every one of us. And God touches us with his finger of love every day and raises us up. So we ought to think that that's, we ought to understand that. Don't we need to do something while we're here? The Bible tells us to redeem the time. You know what that means? You know, do something with your time. When time is gone, you can't get it back. I heard people always say, well, we'll make up some time over here. You're not ever going to make up no time. You either spend it or you use it right then and there or it's gone. Yeah, it's gone. So what you need to do is be where you're supposed to be when you're supposed to be doing what you need to be doing.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. So we can move on and do what God has for us to do in our lives. Faith that pleases God. Scratch your head and say, well, I have faith. I don't know what he keeps telling us that for. Why he keep talking to us about that? We got faith. Scratch your head and say, does your faith please God? Don't. I don't want to know. I'm just asking the question. You answer to yourself. Does your faith please God? Yeah. Does sometimes our faith get hindered by the people we hang around? Does sometimes our faith get hindered about the situation that life gives us? That we forget all about God over here who can do exceedingly and abundantly above anything that we, whatever is going on. We forget about him and we leave God and go start battling that situation. Stirring in it. You know when they say when you're stirring it, you mess it up. I ain't going no further. Y'all pray for me. But that's right, Brother Rosa, stay in a safe place. But we got to understand that with that faith, it has to be worked on. Just like James told us, faith without works is dead. Show me your faith without your works, and I'll show you my faith by my works. See, that's where we need to stand on that is by, I'll show you my faith by my works. I work because I'm saved. I don't work to become saved. Amen. Salvation is a gift of God. He's already laid it out there to us. All we have to do is accept it. It's up to us to accept what he's offered us. That's the bottom line. It has nothing to do with us. Let me tell you, if we would start marking us out of the equation and start saying 1 + 0 + 1 = God and Jesus in our lives. Let's do that. 1 + 1 + 0 is me because I'm nothing in his, I'm nothing. I don't matter. I'm a vessel to be used. See, what we want to do is we want to say 3 + God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit, and me. You know, we're not in that crowd. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We're not in that crowd. But God sent his only begotten Son. Yeah, so that we may have a right to eternal, to pay the penalty, the price. We no longer have to pay that penalty. I heard Brother Daka say this morning that y'all need to really look at that Romans chapter 8, the first verse. That says there is therefore no condemnation to them who are in Christ Jesus. Notice what it says. There is therefore no condemnation to them who are in Christ Jesus. What do you think in Christ Jesus means? Yeah. When we in Christ Jesus, that means we have accepted everything. Christ is now Lord in our lives. We're not making our own decisions and we're not deciding anymore. We run everything through him.
Amen.
If Christ, and then we take the example of what he did. We take that example and we use that. That's the blueprint for us to be in Christ. Be just like Christ was. The scripture tells us, have this mind in you that was also in Christ Jesus.
Yeah.
We got to keep our minds focused. Got to keep our minds stayed on him.
Amen.
See, that's the faith that pleases God, that we go anyway. We go when we don't feel good. We go when we've been hurt. When things come, I can remember I had an auntie that used to take care of us, Aunt Ollie. Aunt Ollie would take care of us, and every day her job was to take care of the kids. My mother didn't work. My grandmother had a job. They all worked. But there was no such thing as latchkey kids during that time because you didn't get to be at home by yourself. So Aunt Ollie would come, and she would watch all the kids. She would watch all the kids. That's what she did every day. She'd come, and she'd go down. And I can remember when Uncle Brandon passed away, her husband. We called him Uncle Shorty. When Uncle Shorty passed away, I can remember that evening after everything was said and done, after she'd gone through the whole ordeal of the day, I can remember her walking up that road that very same day, coming to do what she always did, coming to take care of. She did not take time for her and say, I just lost my husband and I'm grieving and I can't go do what I need. Do you understand what I'm saying? When you're devoted and when you're focused on something, it makes no difference what comes up in the way. You push that out of the way and you keep on moving. And that's what she did. She came on and took care of baby just like nothing had happened. We know she had been in pain 30 or 40 years married to the same person. And then they're gone. But she never forsook the job that she has. Do we do that? Do what we do really please God? Do we forsake the opportunities that God has given us? When he's put it in our plate, when he's laid it out in front of us, this is what I would have you to do. I'm not trying to make anybody feel bad. I'm not picking on anybody. I'm just saying. Amen. It's an opportunity to think and reflect. We come here so we can get better. This is a spiritual hospital. We come here, we can hear the word of God, and we can leave here better than what we came. Yeah, we can grow. And not only that, we can leave here better than what we came, and then we got something to go share with someone else who didn't show up, who didn't get to make it here. That's what it's all about, my sisters and brothers, a faith that pleases God. That faith has to happen all the time, every opportunity, any kind of situation. You got to let your faith come through that is in Christ Jesus. Because remember, whatever else you do, how much money you get, how much stuff you get, and everything we see is temporal. If you can see it, it's getting out of here. Everything we see. But the only thing, he said, heaven and earth may pass away, but not a jot or a tittle of the word will pass away. That's the only thing that's going to last and be in the very end is the word. And you know what that word is? Our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. See, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with him, and the Word. What, you see what I'm talking about? Amen. Jesus is the Word. So Jesus promised, he said, in the beginning I'm here with you, through the middle I'm here with you, and guess what? On the end, I'm going to be standing right here waiting on you. All we have to do is remember that we have a place. He's already called us into what he has. Didn't he do it? He said, he told us, let not our hearts be troubled. Don't trouble your heart. Don't worry about it. If you believed in God, Jesus said, believe also in me. See, I got to go do some work. Jesus worked the whole time that he was here. 3-year ministry, and was able to complete and do everything he did, on top of going to the cross and dying for us and redeeming us back within a 3-year period. Amen. Then he says, my work is not yet finished. As he leaves and ascends, he tells us now, just what I did with you, you go back and make some disciples. You go back and you baptize them in my name. Isn't that what he said? Yes, sir. He told us what to do as he was leaving when I'm gone. He said, but guess what? He said, I'll not leave you comfortless. He said, I got to go, but guess what? I'm going to send the Holy Spirit. To comfort you, to guide you, to lead you, to direct you. He said it in some things. That's what the Holy Spirit is supposed to do, is guide you in some things. All things. In all things. So we were without excuse, my sisters and my brothers. We're out with excuse. There's no reason for us to say, well, if we had known, if the Lord had helped us. Yeah, if it had not been the Lord who was on our side, we wouldn't have made it to where we are right now. So we can't accuse him of not doing anything. He did it all. Jesus paid it all. He paid it all at the cross of Calvary. And guess what? Who benefits from that? Who receives that benefit? Me and you. We receive that benefit of what he does. What great love. What great love that he has shown us. My sisters and brothers, doesn't that kind of tickle us a little bit and say, wow, I've been missing the boat. I could do a little bit better. I might could smile a little bit more. You know, I might could say a kind word. I might could do a random act of kindness. So simply because God has given me the ability to do so. See, we got to learn how to come to church and rejoice. the Lord desires for us to rejoice. See, the last part of that is worship. He desires us to worship him. And when he comes in and worships him, he wants noise in his house. He wants us to be elated. He wants us to be happy about what he's done and everything. Instead of us with our head down, quit letting Satan take your joy. Yeah, yeah. The joy of the Lord is your strength. The joy of the Lord. Keep focusing on that. The joy of your Lord. Quit coming in here all broke down. You don't have to do that. You don't have to do that. You come in here rejoicing. Dance through the door. Come on, dance through the door. Makes no difference. Tell Satan, you can't come with me. When you go through that door, right, Satan, you, there's no place for you in here. See, when we go to rejoicing and praising God, Satan get up and hit that door. He gets up out of here. See, and that's where we need to be a church that loves God to that point that we're not ashamed and we're not worried about what somebody going to say about us. You know, that's unsophisticated. That's not what we do. Now, everybody don't have to jump and dance. Maybe he didn't do all that for you to make you do that. But for me, he did. Now, I'll cut you a step, you know, and I'll praise him. I'll give him glory and I'll give him honor because he's worthy. If it had not been for him, I wouldn't be. I should have been dead and gone a long time ago. With the things I've done, he forgave me, took me, raised me up, cleaned me up, dusted me off, turned me around, and started me on my way. Now, that's enough for me to say, hallelujah. See, I'm all right now because I know he's got me. I know, and he keeps me through it all. He's got me. Come what may, the answer is yes. What do you mean, yes? Yes to your will. Lord, yes to your way. The answer is yes. I don't care what's coming. The answer is yes. Makes no difference what the doctor say, yes to the Lord. Makes no difference what your money looks like when it's funny. Say yes to the Lord. Just trust him in everything that you do. And guess what? God will be pleased with your service. The faith that pleases God. You'll have a faith where you can stand and say, I stand on this solid rock of Jesus Christ, the foundation of everything that I am, everything that I'm going to be. He told us, he said, I'm there. And guess what? Even after he did all that he did, he didn't go home and rest and say, okay, I'm going home with daddy and kick my feet up. He didn't do that. He ascended into heaven and was seated at the right hand of the Father. And guess what he's doing for us right now? Interceding on our behalf. Long distance. Hallelujah.
Thank you. Amen.
Long distance. He's still taking care of us. That ought to excite us. We ought to leave here today and say, you know, I'm okay. My faith, I want to have a faith going to please God because I got all of these bennies over here. I'm talking about bennies, all everything that's in past. Guess what the greatest benny is? Who can give you eternal life? I don't care how good a job you get. Do they have it at the bottom? And eternal life. Huh?
Yeah.
What job do you have? I don't care who it is. Well, I'm working for the government, honey. And eternal life. That's on the benefit package. I don't think so. But he said, just come on board. Come on and be a part of this body of Christ. This body's left. And he said, guess what? Comes along everything else that you come that comes with the package you get. But the greatest thing you have is eternal life. Eternal life. Can you imagine that? You don't die anymore. You live in the presence of God. And guess what? You have a glorified body. You don't have no aches and pains. Hallelujah. 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 No more worrying about the house payment. Y'all don't understand what I'm saying. Y'all don't have to worry about the rent man coming by anymore to collect the money and you don't have it. You don't have to hide in the house and tell the kids to be quiet. You don't have to turn the lights and stuff off. You don't have to take the car over to your uncle's or somebody's house, your best friend, because you can't pay on it. And they coming to get it. You don't have to worry about none of that. You don't need any of that stuff. All of this. Sooner we'll be done with the troubles of this world. We won't have to worry about any of that stuff. See, we're going to go home and be with the Lord. We don't need any of that anymore because he's already taken care of that. Because Jesus said, don't worry about it, fellas. Y'all a little sad because y'all used to being with me and y'all used to seeing me around. But guess what I'm fixing to go do? He said, I got to leave. But as I leave, he said, I'm going to prepare a place for you. Yeah, yeah. He said, and where I go, you're going to get to go too. Don't you know that? Ain't that something? We didn't do nothing to get there, but he said, you're going to get to go too. He said, I love you so much that I'm going to prepare you a place too. There's another home, Jeremy. You ain't got, you get keys. The keys are already been given to you. All you have to do is wait for your home to be built. As soon as your mansion gets ready, comes and gets you. Okay, Jeremy, yours is ready. Next. See, that's how he does it, because he promised that. He promised it, didn't he? And we got to learn how to stand on the promises of God. Hallelujah. 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 The faith that pleases God. We got to stand in that faith that pleases God. Makes no difference what comes. Makes no difference about how hard it may seem or how hard it may be to you. We got to understand that good things are happening. Would you come here just a minute? Got a certain song I wanted him to play back there. And if you would tell him, would you tell him that? Because we got to understand that God is not through with us better days. Yeah, we got to understand that. You know, God has got so much in store for us. Do you know that? Can you imagine? He even says, eyes have not seen, ears have not heard, neither has entered into the heart of man the things that God has in store for those who, he said, love me. Love me. We can't even imagine what that is. But today is the first day of the rest of your life. If you don't know Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, start brand new. Start your life brand new today, walking with him. You don't have to walk alone anymore. You don't have to go through anything. You don't have to go through situations. You don't have to go through circumstances. Everything is going to be all right. We're going to trust him. Will you trust him today? Will you trust him in everything that's going on? Not just some things. Not just a few things. What a friend. What a friend we have in Jesus. All our sins and grief to bear. Guess what it is? It says, what a privilege. It is a privilege to care. Everything. Everything to God in prayer. Don't hold back nothing. Don't hold back from him, because he already knows. He desires. He wants to bless us. I would that you would have life and have it more abundantly. He's got all of this stuff that he's created just for us. Just for the taking. He's waiting for us to have enough faith to believe. I'm going to call it out. He says, speak those things that are not as though they were. And you might not see it. Might not have materialized yet, but you got to trust him for it anyway. Lord, I don't know. I can't see it. I don't know where it is, but I know it's coming. I don't know how it's coming, but I know you're going to do it. Because you said you would, and you cannot lie. God can't lie. You know why I can't lie? Because God can make anything happen. God can't lie. He don't need to lie. Anything he wants to happen, he can make it happen at any given time, because he's God. Amen. So whatever's going on in your life today, if you got some trouble and you're a little shame, you think, I don't want nobody to know what's going on. Well, that's what Satan wants you to say, because Satan desires to keep us bound. You don't have to be bound today. You can be free in Christ Jesus. All you have to do is say, Lord, I trust you with my life. Lord, you guide me and direct me. Lord, I ask you to forgive me of my sins and my sinfulness, and you're done with it. Lord, accept me into your kingdom. And guess what? He reaches down and he grabs us up and he hugs us. And guess what? That wagon that you carry with all that mess that you done carried for, some of us done got a big wheel bar. Some of us have got big and long way. Some of us have got some wheels on our trailer, because we're dragging that stuff with us. Right. All of that, you get to unhook that trailer. Yes, sir. You get to leave all that long, because he casts your sins as far as the east is from the west. Amen. It's over. It's done with. Clean slate. Amen? Amen. Ain't that good news? Yes, sir. Ain't that good news? Will you trust him on today? Will you trust him in your life on today? Whatever's going on in your life, trust him, because guess what? Better days are coming.
the best is yet to come. We haven't seen it all. We got to trust Him. We got to trust Him.
Sometimes.
Hallelujah.
Yeah, yeah.
It feels cold.
Yeah, it does.
And you feel all alone.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah.
But
hallelujah.
Hold on, better days are coming.
Hallelujah. 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 Take your seat. That's what I'm talking about. Hallelujah. Yeah, yeah, yeah. See, that's what it's all about.
I know it ain't easy, but hang on in there.
Hang in there.
I know better.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Stay in it. Stay in the game.
Are coming.
Yeah.
You sing